Well, you've decided to go on a road trip like we do here on this channel quite often. As a matter of fact, last year we did 8,550 miles specifically on road trips, and we documented all of that and shared that with you. And every time we post one of our videos, which we're about to post the one we're on right now, I get a lot of questions. So I wanted to take this time to give some recommendations and talk about what it's like to road trip in a Tesla. So we've had our Model Y since April of last year, and we've taken numerous road trips. And right now we're down in Florida for spring break, spending some time, a little bit of R&R, and just like every other road trip, there is some planning that goes into it. So for today, we're going to talk about what type of planning we do, what tools we use, some of the things that you're gonna wanna make sure you have with you on your trip. So this is not an all-encompassing list, and there are some other things to consider that other people are probably going to share in the comments. So it may be worth scrolling through there to see if anything else pops up that might be a good idea for you to consider as well. So the first thing we're gonna talk about is apps. There are two apps that you absolutely need to have if you plan on doing much road tripping in your Model Y. Even without road tripping, one of these apps you're gonna wanna have anyway. So first and foremost is PlugShare. In your Tesla, you'll be able to see destination chargers and superchargers, but there are a number of other public chargers available, as well as some hotels that are in PlugShare. Whenever we go on road trips, there's usually at least one night that we stop at a hotel, and along the way, I try to find a hotel on our route that has a destination charger. PlugShare allows you to do this. So once you find a hotel that has a destination charger, you can then decide that may be the right hotel for you to stay at. Then you can wake up and have a fully charged car and continue on your road trip. This can save you a ton of time when road tripping far distances. Also, whenever you get to your destination and it's a foreign area, you're not used to it, it is nice to know where local chargers are. Even if you're just taking a day trip, being able to figure out where public chargers may be located that you can take advantage of while you're there. It's a lot simpler to have your car parked and charging at the same time if possible, and PlugShare is pretty good. People do like to update the status of those chargers. Some of them go offline, some of them are broken, so on and so forth. So once you select one, you can see some of the details on it, what type of charging it is, what kind of adapter it uses, things like that, that can help you better plan. Now, the next app is one of my absolute favorite tools when owning a Tesla, and that is abetterrouteplanner.com. Their app is incredible. I don't know how they pulled it off, but it takes in so many factors and it's very customizable. So you're gonna put your starting location as well as your destination. And what it is going to do is allow you to change things like, how fast am I gonna go? For me, I always leave it at 110% of the posted speed limit. So it factors in that speed. It also factors in how much battery degradation you know that you have. Also what kind of consumption your car generally gets, things like that. And you can add in even the weather. And what it's going to do is factor in how far you're gonna go and when you're gonna need to stop. The thing I like about this better than the built-in navigation in the Tesla is that it goes for efficiency, trying to get you from point A to point B as quickly as possible. So more short stops at chargers than in the Tesla. The Tesla is going to want to stop, charge all the way up to get a very long stretch. A better route planner already has some AI built into it. It's gonna try to get you there the quickest way possible. What's also nice is you can set when you're planning to depart. It'll tell you when you'll arrive, how long you'll be charging, how long at each stop. Plus, you can say at this particular charging stop on this route, I want to stop for 30 minutes or I want to eat or whatever. And you can fully customize your trip, and then you'll have it completely laid out in front of you. I use this tool before absolutely every trip, and I do this for planning purposes only. You can of course use it for navigation as well, which I do not, but for planning, I can figure out what time I need to leave to get to where I wanna go, approximately what time. It's also going to give me a heads up on areas I wanna avoid or specific routes that I wanna take. When I get into the car, I then just plug in the destination and I go. And sometimes I follow where it tells me to stop, but other times I don't. And by having done the pre-planning with a better route planner, I now know which chargers to look for along the way. So that's it. Those two apps are must-haves. There are plenty of other apps that are also useful, but those two specific for road trips are fantastic to have.
I want to thank the sponsor of this video, Phantom Wallet. Phantom Wallet offers premium wallet designs with an aluminum chassis with options of wood, leather, and carbon fiber finishes. Grab the cards you need with a quick flip of the lever. RFID and NFC protection are built in, ensuring a safe and secure alternative to traditional options. Make sure to use code BTG to save 10% on your order.
One of the other things that I want to talk about is, with all these road trips that we've done, we have figured out a ton of things that are wasteful, some things that are must-have, stuff like that. And I'm going to go through that list now, because some of these things you may not even think about right now. So many of you who have watched our road trip videos before have seen an iPad holder sitting right up here, and that thing has come in absolutely clutch on our road trips. We have two young boys, so sticking the iPad up here close to our head level is perfect. They both get a great view from the iPad, and mom and dad can control it without having to reach back there too far. It just attaches via suction cup straight to the glass on top, and it works phenomenally. I highly recommend this if you have young children that you don't necessarily want them to hold on to the iPad through the whole trip. Next is iPhone holders. So of course the car has this wireless charger down here at the bottom, and that's a great place for your iPhone. If, however, you are like me, you like to have a visual line to your phone. Sometimes I plug in Waze and I need to be able to see that without looking too far down. I actually have two now, and I am testing which one I like the most. Originally, we got this top fit adapter that just goes straight over the screen, and I love this thing. It is wirelessly charging as well, and it also opens and closes to grab onto your phone. It puts the phone in a really good spot. I really like the location. You can tilt it sideways, vertical, whatever, but it's also got a place for your sunglasses, which we also use, so it works out really well. I like it a lot. The only thing I don't like is sometimes I don't want to charge it because it gets hot sitting there right in front of the sun, so that is one of the things I don't like about it. Now for this trip, I got a new iPhone holder, and this one, again, very simple, but it attaches to the glass right here to the left side. Now this is a little bit farther out of reach than this one by the screen. However, I am liking it a lot. So these are two ideal holders that I have found so far. It's nothing too crazy, but I do like them, and I highly recommend getting one or the other, because you're gonna wanna have a good spot for your phone to be located without being too distracting. Now, the next thing you have to have the space for, and that is going to be completely dependent on how much stuff you bring with you. If you have the luxury of leaving your frunk empty, you are going to have the space for the front cooler. Evan-X makes this front cooler, and I love this thing. I took it on my solo trip to Key West. I put some ice in it, and I just left all my drinks in there, and it worked great. I put ice in it about every day. It does get pretty hot under that frunk in the direct sunlight, so it does a great job of keeping the ice cool, but it can only go so far. However, it holds so much stuff, and I love this frunk cooler. Highly, highly recommend getting it if you have the space to afford putting it in the frunk. No longer do you have to worry about finding a place to stop, get some drinks or something cold to eat, whatever. It's all right there. I love it, love it, love it. I use it all the time, especially when we have the room for it. So the next thing that you absolutely have to have, of course, are charging adapters. And I want to go through this really quickly because the car comes with a 110 outlet plug on your mobile charger. Make sure you have a backup charger if you're going to be taking your primary one with you on road trips. Once you do, of course, the 1450, although is not the only adapter for this, it is pretty widely used across the country. So have that 1450 adapter for it, bring that with you as well. In addition, if you're going to be near campgrounds or you're going to utilize a campground, a lot of them come with a 30 amp plug. You cannot simply get an adapter from 30 to 50 amps because it's not wired the way it needs to be for the mobile charger to work. You have to get a special one. I'll put one in the description that worked well for us. I keep it in the car all the time. And speaking of adapters, make sure you always have a very good extension cord in your car. Mine is 25 foot. I probably could go for one that was even longer, but it comes handy in a pinch. Even if you can only draw 110 from somewhere, it's better than nothing in an emergency. Plus, if you're staying at a hotel, if you ask, generally they'll let you plug into one of the outlets outside. You're not gonna get a ton of range out of it, but you will get some. 30, 40 miles overnight works out pretty well. So this next one I just recently got, and based on experience, I was drawn to this particular design. there are two USB-C plugs right here in the back, and both of those plugs are great for our passengers in the back. We can keep the iPads plugged in and charged and things like that. However, we have broken so many plugs, and we're talking like Apple branded plugs have been completely broken because they stick straight out, and as you're picking things up, moving them around, it's very easy to break them. So I came across these are not cheap, and they are pretty premium. They are nice, but the design is where it's at. So these things are like close to 20 bucks a piece. So again, kind of pricey, but totally worth it. These things mount flush, and you no longer have to worry about breaking these things as you're picking stuff up and out. It's way more out of the way, not sticking out so much, and a lot better for this application. Highly, highly recommend getting these plugs for the back of the car. Of course, any road trip is going to come with dirt and debris. Make sure you have floor liners in your car. Regardless, anything is better than nothing. I personally love these MaxSpire floor mats. I cannot talk enough about how much I love these floor mats. You've seen me recommend them in a number of videos. I still highly recommend them. There's a discount code. You can get 10 bucks off your set, but get something. Highly recommend these MaxSpires. They are fantastic. I just cleaned them before this trip, and I already have sand in here from being on the beach all week. So easy to clean, keeps the inside of the car well protected. I love these floor mats. All right, so there's another thing that we did while we were here. As a matter of fact, I found a mobile tinting service that offered a brand of tint that I was a fan of. I don't know why I've been putting this off so long, but I have yet to tint these windows until now. So now that we're on vacation, I was able to coordinate with a local mobile guy to meet me at the supercharger. As a matter of fact, the one I'm sitting at right now, to put this window tint on the front of the car. I love this. It looks great. This is 25%. It is a very good match to the back. It's a more consistent look on the side. This window tint is Expel Prime XR, and it has 99% UV and 88% heat rejection. Now, window tint alone is not going to stop the car from getting to a maximum heat over time. There's no way to stop that completely. However, while I'm driving down the road, I can tell you immediately I notice a difference. I get really warm up here because the window, when the sun is coming through, it gets me really warm, and my passenger over here, my wife, she's usually cold. So these work great, and I love the way that they look. This is a ceramic tint, and it is going to hold up very well over time. I am so glad that I finally pulled the trigger and got window tint in the car. Another thing that's actually worked out really surprisingly well are these storage cubes. You see these everywhere at any store you go to. They're very simple, nothing crazy about them, but they collapse and they fold and store really nice. We actually use them for snacks. So we put it right here in the middle where we can reach it, so we can get the boys snacks or snacks for ourselves. And it's easy to pull out, put somewhere else, and store away. Highly recommend these. I have two of them in my car when we go on road trips. One for snacks, one for activities. You should really think about getting some of these, especially if you have kids. And then finally, of course, if you do have kids, there's nothing more important than protecting the inside of this car. We ended up getting these new seat covers once we got this car. What I like about these is they go all the way up the back of the seat rather than just the bottom. These have saved us from Cheerios and crayons and you name it. Stains have been eliminated because of these seat covers, and I highly recommend them if you do have kids. And now another accessory that I just got for this trip specifically is I got this cover up here, and it was pretty inexpensive, or at least reasonably priced, and it comes in a carrying case. It attaches with these clips, and I think there's 8 of them. So I've got 3 on the sides and 1 in the middle in the front, 1 in the middle in the back, and it does a really good job of blocking out the sun. It's super dark in here actually, and it threw me off at first because it's usually so bright and sunny in here. But the nice thing is, when it's hotter outside or you're, you know, traveling to a very sunny place, it's nice to have the flexibility of adding that and taking it off later. So I'm really glad that we got this. It does sag. It's not perfect, but it does actually touch the corners very well. It's a good fit. Just kind of sags a little bit. And everything I saw online for all the products, they all pretty much sag some. And it's going to be pretty hard to get this to not do that. But the good thing is it's way up here, way above my head. So it's not like it's resting on my head. So Another thing to take a look at and see if it's worth getting, depending on where you're going. Finally, another thing to consider is getting PPF on the front of the car. There's nothing you can do about the bugs and debris that are going to smack the front of this car. It is truly a bug magnet, and that is because it's just so big and flat and it catches everything. This particular PPF is a DIY kit. I'll put a link up above of how to do that install. It was reasonably inexpensive, and I am pleased with the application and how it turned out. It's not going to look like a professional finish because you're not a professional, but I think it turned out great, and it has saved us at least twice from some probably pretty good damage on the front of the car. We had our second hit from a big chunk of something on the highway at highway speeds on this trip. This PPF cover has saved us at least twice. So highly recommend, if you're going to be doing road trips, protect at least the front of the car, not just ceramic. You need something, a sacrificial barrier that will protect the car. So there you have it. If you're planning on, like us, going on numerous road trips, those are my recommendations for how to do this successfully and happily. I hope that you enjoyed this video. Of course, give it a thumbs up if you did. If you haven't already, of course, subscribe to the channel as we continue to post content regularly. You can follow us on Twitter and Instagram at Bearded Tesla. Thanks so much for joining us, and we'll catch you next time.